think about the generations and to say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children so that they know it's a better world for them and think if they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place was brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow.
My name is Monique Rivard, and Bobby Tillman is my son. And he was murdered on November 7th. He was chosen by four teenagers, not much older than you guys, maybe even the same age as you. And they beat him, they stomped him, they broke one of his ribs and punctured his heart. And Bobby was 5'6", and he weighed 125 pounds. They didn't even know my son's name. They picked him at random because of something they didn't like about him. And what every child in here should know, and even adults, said, what makes you different is what makes you special. And everyone here has something special about them that God has given them. And it's not wrong to let it shine. It's not wrong to recognize it in someone else because you have it in yourself. Yours may not be hers, but yours is just as special. And that's where everyone is. No reason to bully, to pick on people, to laugh at people for things that are, for one, out of their control. And for two, is their chosen right. You all have the right to be who you want to be, to do what you want to do with your life, as long as it's the right one.
Good evening.
My name is Monica Hernandez. What's up, you know me? My last name is Monica, 16, 2009, suicide, queen. His name was Jackie Rivera. I'm here to help parents, you know, and kids. If you're going through any bullying, you can contact me. What happened to my son should have never happened to him. You know, he made me do a lot in that school. They used to call him gay, virgin, because he's from the Virgin Islands. And he reached to the point that he couldn't take it anymore, and he hung himself in class. You know, and that's the image I have in my mind for the rest of my life.
This so-called celebrity status that they give you for being on TV, I make sure that I'm doing something conscious. First and foremost, y'all gotta make sure what you put into your ears turns into your actions. Right? So if you use an action, y'all need to sign up for your
conference.
I'm fine. Thank you for allowing me to be on your show.
show today.
Okay. Like,
what are some of the programs that are going to be? Stop, we're going to be having workshops by youth. This conference is created by youth for youth, and we're going to have classes by youth. It's just a youth perspective on bullying and people that have been affected by bullying. That's what we're going to be doing, having class.
Great. So what advice do people give to a child that's been bullied?
I would have to say tell an adult, and if an adult doesn't help you, call the nearest bully hotline that you can call on the internet, and they'll take care of the bullying in your school.
Okay, so what is the overall goal and who do you think such a start, okay?
The overall goal is to have sponsors, because I know some organizations do not have sponsors, and it's really hard because my mom had to pay most of this money out of pocket. So it's just kind of, it's not always what you know, but who you know.
Mm-hmm.
But the overall goal is to get sponsors and everything to be taken care of.
Okay, that's great. So tell us a little bit about your book, Easy Street Ain't So Easy.
Easy Street Ain't So Easy is about a group of teens, group of teenage girls that go through different issues in a middle class neighborhood that people wouldn't even really believe. And the reason why I wrote Easy Street Ain't So Easy is to kind of let people know that these particular issues can happen anywhere. No matter if you're a middle class, or higher class neighborhood, they can happen. Website www.youthinactionusa.com.
Gotta keep